Jesus, sorry, is alive, is alive, is alive, Savior is. Jesus is alive forevermore. He's alive to break the yokes and to set the captives free. He lives forevermore. He lives upon the strong. He's alive to heal the sick and to save our wandering souls. Jesus is alive again. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. My Savior is alive. Jesus is alive forevermore. He's alive. He's alive. Alive. My Savior is alive. Jesus is alive forevermore. He's alive. He's alive to break the yoke and to set the captives free. So he lives forevermore. Because it's alive, it's a living God. Hallelujah to your name. You are the living Father, we worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah to your name. Thank you, Jesus. He's alive again. He's no longer where he was asleep. He's alive again. The stone has been rolled away. He's alive again. Let all the world rejoice. He's alive, he's alive. He's alive again. He's no longer where he was slain. He's alive again. The stones have rolled away. He's alive again. And I know the angels said, let all the world rejoice. He's alive. He's alive again. He's alive again. But no longer was he. He's alive again. The stone that rolled away. He's alive again. And I know the angels said that all the world.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. I refuse to comply with.
covenant,
every evil covenant
made by me or on my behalf,
made by me or on my behalf,
and I break them away with the blood of Jesus. Begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Young people, children, begin to pray that too. I refuse to comply with every evil covenant made by me on my behalf. I break them away with the blood of Jesus. Mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Release me today.
Release
you will
me.
Pray this prayer with all your body. Blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Deliver me today.
Deliver me today.
From any power that passes through dream to torture my life.
From every power.
Begin to pray in the name of Jesus. So meditate against my calling and ministry. Blood of Jesus, deliver me this morning. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The bread of the Lord has made me.
The bread of the Lord has
made me. The Spirit of the Lord has given me life.
The Spirit of the Lord has given me life.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Quickly return to your seats. God bless you. Amen. Father, we thank you for what you have done this morning. We thank you for you are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Have your way this morning. Take control, Lord. Move mightily in this service. Father, and deliver your word to your people. Lord, let their hearts receive. Let their mind register. And let their life begin to manifest. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I put under control and detention every buying and selling spirit, powers, principality, distracting spirit, spirit of the power of darkness that is hired to steal away the word of God from the heart of man. Spirit that have turned to the board that want to pick away the seed of the word of God. I command it to be arrested now. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
The power that made people hear the word and will not allow them to live by it. I place you under destruction this morning. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
Let the spirit of obedience descend, O Lord.
Amen.
Let the power to comply with your word be released in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the spirit of truth come down, O Lord.
Amen.
And change your spirit, soul, and body.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 So this morning, the Lord wants us to have a church without sin, like I told you. A church without sin. Or wrinkle. He wants us to always be on Mount Zion, the church of the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 22 to 24. The church on Mount Zion, the church where there's no sin, the church that is registered in heaven, recognized individually. Amen. This morning we are going to remind ourselves about the coming of the Lord Jesus. That is the assignment that he has given me. To go into all the world and preach the gospel to all people. That those who believe will be saved. Those who believe will be saved. Preaching the gospel of the Lord Jesus to all people. And those who do not believe will be condemned. Preaching of the message of the cross is my calling. I don't have another calling. Reminding people about things over and over and over. So this morning, I was asking the Lord from yesterday night, what is the message today? What is the message today? And to cut the long story short, he wants me to remind us about his coming. His coming is closer than you think. It's much, much closer than you can ever think. It's coming. since I was young, I have been hearing Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. People do not know that before the Lord, the Bible says one day is like what?
A thousand years.
But the time is up. Acts chapter 1 from verse 9. Acts chapter 1 from verse 9. Acts chapter 1. How do we help Mama that speaks Swahili now? But anyway, the Lord will touch your heart. It will minister to you in its different way. Amen. Yes, Acts chapter 1, verse 9.
Acts chapter 1, verse 9, I read.
Yeah.
And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
So that is one thing you must understand. When Jesus Christ resurrected, because we will not have time to go into all the from verse 1. I just want to pick up all the Bible passages I will read. I want to take verses, so that we can go quick. Amen. So when he came back to life, when he resurrected, some of the disciples thought that was the time to restore back the kingdom that he was talking about. They thought that was the time he had to take them back to his kingdom. So they said, so what do you mean, Lord? Are we not going? He said, no, that's not now. It's not now, because they confirmed that he was risen from the dead. So he said, it's not now. This kingdom I'm talking about is when I go and I come back. The angels, when he was lifted out of their presence, the Bible says he went, like human being, like this. And the Bible says he was lifted up, and they were looking at him. They were looking at him disappear into the sky. And the angels were around. You remember when he rose up, when he woke from the dead, there were angels at the what? At the place where he was buried. And they told Mary and the other Mary that he was risen, he was no longer here. And these angels too were there also to tell them that the same way you see him going, just like he told you before, he will be coming the same way one day. He will be coming the same day with his glory one day. And this time around, not to preach. You know, he came before to preach. He showed mercy. He was very merciful. But if you know where Jesus is now, during the week, sometimes I was talking with my wife in the car, I said, if you have chance to look at Jesus now, the way people behave, you will see him crying. He went through a lot of things for you and I. Do you think he found it easy and funny to go to cross? The Bible said when it was few moments before time, he was praying in Gethsemane. And it was even when he saw, because he saw everything the way it would happen. And he said, Lord, my Father, if it was possible, let this cup go over me. What was he saying? He said, if it's possible, don't let it be like this. All this thing I see is too hard. But the Lord did not look at that direction. The Lord was concerned about the salvation of everyone that will come. Why did that have to happen? I have told us many times. Because the first kingdom, the first place that the Lord provided, which is the heart, it has been polluted. God did not create the heart of sin. God wanted holiness to be on heart. God wanted obedience to be on heart. God wanted good life. Like my parents used to tell me before they died, that in those days, in their villages, when they're in the market, they'll put their things they sell. And people will come
They will see, they will put price there. People will come, they will put money, they put stone on the money, and they will carry the thing and they go. But today, even with you, beside your own market, they will be like, they will take your, you just carry your thing and go. Some of them will not like to pay. Because immorality or righteousness have pervaded the heart. So the heart is polluted. And the Lord, whenever the thing gets to the climax, the Lord wants to separate. He wants to separate the evil from the bad. And how does he do that? By removing all the evil, removing all the good and destroying the rest. He did that to the children of Israel in the wilderness. When they were making him angry, he told Moses, make a serpent, I want to do something. And he told him what to do. And he sent fiery serpent to begin to bite. And people were dying. And he gave instructions. He said, only anyone that look at the one that you made, those are the ones that will live. Why? That was not the medicine. But God decided to do that to see their obedience. That only anyone that believe in what you say, those that will live. Everybody that don't believe what you say, that will not look at that serpent on the image of the serpent, will die. He did it also at the time of Noah. When unrighteousness pervaded, he said, I will separate this wicked from the good. Noah, build me a heart. And he told him the dimensions of how to build it. And Noah did. For many years, it was a huge one, provided for huge people. But only one family entered, and animals, surprisingly. The Bible says, animals, over everything that the Lord created, the Lord regretted only creating one being. Oh, you didn't see the book of Genesis. How many people have seen that? Say, when I look at the man that I created, he grieved my heart that I've made man in my image. Animal can hear word more than human being. All you just need to do is to train them. But human being, So what I'm saying is, I want to remind us, as according to what God wants us to know this morning, the coming of the Lord Jesus is coming back very soon. And that is why I touch those areas for you to remember, because those are not my messages. I just want you to know what happened whenever the situation is getting out of hand. Sodom and Gomorrah, they got out of hand, and the Lord created difference. There was no much people, according to the pleading of Abraham. How many people? Lot, the children, even the wife could not make it on the road. So this time around, we are sounding the same warning. Jesus is coming. You need to be obedient to his message. You need to repent from all your ways. You need to repent from all the sins. Because this body does not go to heaven. Let me tell you, this body does not go to heaven. Flesh and blood does not go there. But why will you not allow the body to make your soul to be tormented? I tell people all the time that this is not you. As you see my body is not me. The voice that is coming out of me is me. And that voice is what goes to heaven. When the people that died and the Lord took the heaven will tell you, they will say when they came out of their body, they saw their body. But they have another body. And they saw their heavenly body on the bed, and they move away to the life, to the world of unknown. And there, it leaves you with your destiny. Everything you have done on heart, as soon as you drop that breath, it's finished. Then it leaves you with your destiny. Then the work that you have done on heart will be following you. Unrighteousness, immoralities, lie, theft, adultery, and fornication, everything will be following you at the back. And those are the ones that will be making judgment at every junction that you go through. This is not lie, this is real, my people. I beseech you in the name of God. I want the Lord to touch your heart this morning to listen to this message. I might not finish it because I don't have enough time. But I will try as much as possible to move quickly. Every revelation that happened in the time past and now were recorded in the Bible. Major prophets, when I mean major prophets, I mean the prophets that walk with the kings and big prophets, but and the minor prophets too, the prophet that you know little or nothing about. Those minor prophets like Nahum, Habakkuk, and so on and so forth. So, the major prophet, they prophesy about the coming of the Lord, even before he was born. The same prophet that prophesied about the birth of the Lord Jesus, and he came to life, he was born. They prophesy also about the time he would die and resurrected, and the time he will come back for the rapture. Let us read the book of Daniel quickly. I just want to read two from the prophet. Daniel chapter 12. And the second one will be in Zephaniah chapter 1. Daniel chapter 12. Are we in Daniel? Chapter 12. I read quickly from verse 1. At the time, Michael shall stand up. Who is Michael? The archangel. Michael, this is the prophecy of the prophet Daniel now. Michael shall stand up, and the great prince who stands watch over the sons of your people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation, even to that time. And at the time, your people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the house shall wake. Do you hear that in the New Testament too?
Yes.
He says, anyone that is delivered, anyone that found true salvation, that's what it means, that their names are written in the book, they will be saved. And the dead in Christ shall rise. That was Prophet Daniel here. Some to everlasting life. Some to shame and everlasting contempt. Those that believe and say, we go to, and those that believe the life of Christ daily, we go to heaven. And the sinners will go to hell. Verse 3 says, those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the firmament, and those who turn away to righteousness like the stars forever. Who are those that are wise? Anyone that accept Jesus Christ, anyone that came to this world and failed to repent from their sin or accept the Lord Jesus Christ, they are the people that I used to call the most foolish people. Any smart human being that lives, we know that the life without Christ is the present trouble and the future torment. Present trouble and the future torment. I would not like to dwell too much in explaining them too much because of time. But I know that you know what I'm talking about. The Holy Spirit will translate further to you. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 15 to 18. We will still read. And Revelation 20, 13 to 15. We will see read. And you can write it to anyone that is open, any of them, you let me know when we finish reading this. Now, but you, Daniel, shall shut up the walls and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase, and so on and so forth. Those are the signs of the end time. The Bible let us know that when the time is always up, knowledge will increase. Strange things will begin to happen. As I'm talking to you now, many nations are getting permission to be doing gay marriages in the registry and in the churches. And the government is giving permission. You know, it's not the kind of seeking permission of the church. It's like a decreeing and commanding the church that they must, if they put it into law, the church has no right. They have no option but to wed the men and women together. How can that be? forcing the church to wed a man and man, woman and woman, because they have passed it as law. France has passed it as law. England, they are debating on their own. Some countries in Europe, they have already joined. America, they done their own long time ago. And these people, they are minority. These gay and homosexual and lesbian, they are small people. How come they have that kind of power to change nations' law? Then you know that it has to do with spiritual things. How can small minority power people have power to make impact, to change a constitution of a country to favor them? You will know that it's not ordinary. So, my people, what am I saying? The hand is come. The other day I was checking on the internet, I saw flying cats that is flying. Have you ever seen cats? But they were crossbreeding. They crossbreed. They put the semen of a cat, of bird into cat, and they now begin to produce. For instance, before I said to myself, before I see snake flying, I will be out of this world, because these people cannot cause me out of that before I go. Because I don't know what is happening anymore. Flying cat, flying rabbit. Later, I will now begin to see walking fish, crossbreeding, and all those kind of things. You see some dog, they are like 10 years, they are just small like that. Crossbreeding. Doing many abominable things. We will soon get there quickly. Oh, I wish I had time for this message. Can we open to that First Thessalonians? Who is opening? Yes, ma'am. You tell us where you are.
Four. From verse 15 or?
13.
From verse 13 says, mm-hmm. 1 Thessalonians 4:13. Mm-hmm. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus, we God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven.
The Lord will descend from heaven, just like it was said in Acts, that as you see him going, he will come down like that from heaven one day. Yes?
With a shout of joy, with the voice of the archangel.
Amen. You see, there was a movie that we watched yesterday night in my house. It was a little bit late, but it was like rapture. You know, rapture took place and there was the moment of torture and all that. But when they want to show the manifestation of the Lord Jesus, if you see the something that came on the background like music, it was very, I don't know how to describe it. That is how the coming of the Lord will be. We just begin, the heaven will change. The atmosphere will change. I'm telling you, the Bible says we'll still come there. It said every eye will see it. Not only the people that will go alone, because the people that will go alone will not even wait to see. They will have gone. But the other people that are not gone, they will see it. Say, what is this? But the Bible says some people that have heard about it, they will know it's rapture. Some people that you have been preaching to since, they have been in and out of the church. They don't repent. They don't do anything. He said, my sister, please. They will now begin to call the important people. He said, if I call pastor, I know that it's not rapture. If you pick it, hello? He ran, grand. I will not pick call that time in Jesus' name. I will be out of town. He called, ring. Hey! He told the boy, let me call the wife. Hey, let me call this Uwa. You know, they will just be calling those people. Hey, let me call this Jamila. Let me call. Okay, let me try this Antonia, because Ahu was too much. Hey, I did that. This is rapture. This is rapture. Hey. You will see everybody on the street like a mad person. Some people will not even wear clothes from their house because they know that they are in trouble. Anyone that fails to go with that rapture is in trouble. Can you finish it, man? The music will just the Bible said the color of the sky will change, and the crowd, the Son of God will manifest in glory with his angels. Musical background. So I don't know how it will be that day, but I will give him my own son. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It will be the kind of speaker that no speaker will be able to hear. We'll come with sun. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. If you know how to sing, the angel of heaven will beat you in song. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh God Almighty, da 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 da, oh da, hallelujah, hallelujah, da 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 da. Everybody will be shaking.
Amen.
Oh! And the Bible says, within the tingle of the heart,
yes,
every children of God is gathered up in the four corners of the heart, and they are gone.
Jesus.
It's just like, open the door, carry and close. Open the door, carry and close. And the rest people are left. For how long? First. That is prelimo. The real cause has gone, that is dessert. For how long first? How many people know?
3.5 years.
How many people know? Is that what the Bible says? 3.5 years. How long will the devil, the Satan, rule the heart? Now, Revelation 20, I read quickly. Then I saw an angel coming from the heavens, having the key to the bottomless pit and the great chain in his hand. He laid hold. I jump forward. And I saw thrones, and they sat on them, and judgments was committed to them. Then I saw the souls of those who had beheaded their witness, Jesus, and all the world of God who had not worshipped the beast. And okay, this is the second departure now. This is the second departure after the people that did not receive the mark of the beast. Because it will be another opportunity, but I will come to that. So I just want to, so that I will not lose course from what I'm talking about. I want us to focus on the coming of the Lord. Because if it's a Bible study now, we'll be able to sort it very much. But it's a preaching Sunday service. I just want to go straight to my subject so that I will not deviate from there. So my purpose is to let you know that the Son of Man is coming. And the coming is imminent. It is not joke. It is not fake. It is not fairy tale. It is real. Everything that the Bible prophesied happened. Every prophecy. It is not by mistake that many prophets deliver this message. Both major prophet and the minor prophet deliver the message that the Son of God will come back. They give prophecy about his birth, how it will be stage by stage, the places they will take him to. Nazareth, Egypt. Everything happened, just like Prophet Isaiah said it. Therefore, his coming too is real. It is not for nothing that the Lord has delayed his coming. It's because of you and I. Imagine if God had come 10 years ago, where would I be? The things I know now, I didn't know them those 10 years. So therefore, God is tarrying because of you and I, that you have opportunity to know more things. Believe me, some of the things you know now, some people don't even know it now, they are still in churches. Some people, what they know is just to go to church, pray, sing, and go home. Because they don't understand how can holiness living be? How can you live righteous? And the Bible says if you are not holy, you cannot see God. That's my last part. I will soon come to that. Matthew chapter 24. Matthew 24. I want a very fast reader to help me here. From verse 7.
Matthew 24 from verse 7.
Can we read from verse 4?
4. And Jesus answered and said unto them,
yes,
take heed that no man deceive you.
Then don't let anybody deceive you.
For many shall come in my name.
Many will come in my name.
Saying, I am Christ.
Uh-huh.
I shall deceive many.
Yes.
For ye shall hear of wars and rumors of war.
Yes.
See that ye be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet come. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, mm-hmm. and there shall be famine and pestilence and earthquakes mm. in diverse places.
Mm.
All these are the beginning of sorrow.
Now, hold on. Mm. Now, if you want to be frank with yourself, are these things happening or not?
Yes.
The kind of tsunami I never knew when I was young. They gave tsunami many names. Tsunami Katrina, Hurricane Katrina, very soon we'll see Hurricane Elizabeth. And many things, they gave many things many names. Because they were just coming up and they're just happening and you're so happening. And that's what the Bible says, they will be happening when the Lord Jesus is about to come. Rumors of war and war every place will be rising up. Yes?
Verse 9. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. And many false prophets shall rise, and shall deceive many. 12.
Now, hold on. Because I want to be able to help you to understand that the coming of the Lord Jesus is at hand. As we are talking now, we have even more fake prophets more than the new one. There are so many that even people don't want to believe the truth. And their purpose is just to mislead people. Because somebody that has been battered by many false prophets, will you believe any other good one that comes? You just say, oh, that is the way all that. We don't even believe all those things. And some people will stay at home with deception to lead them to hellfire. They will say, I don't want to go to church again. They hold this thing and they stay at home. They don't know that God, there is no excuse because of a pastor that make you sit down at home. Heaven does not know that. You say, Jesus, I tried, but that pastor that have that ugly face that make me come to this place, he was just misbehaving. I just decided to stay at home. They say, we don't concern with that. You hold your life. You are responsible for where you go, whether heaven or hell. And if possible, they will say, that pastor you are complaining about, look at him here. He's over a few miles away from you there. Look at him there. Because that one too will be there. Many pastors will be in hell. Many evangelists will be in hell. Many bishops will be in hell. Many preachers, prophets will be in hell. In fact, prophets of this generation, majority of them will be in hell because of the prophecy they give. Because most of them are not from God. But they want to say it because they want people to know that they are prophets and prophetess. It is more dangerous for the gift of prophecy is very dangerous. It's good, but very risky, delicate. It requires people that are very sentimental, people that are very spiritual, people that are seeking the face of God. God, is it you? Before I speak out, I don't want to make mistakes because of revelation to go to hellfire. And the purpose is to mislead people. And it says, what again? They will to deceive many and become lawless. Lawlessness will abound, and the love of many will go cold. You see, because of all this misbehavior, malpractices, corruption, all this disgraceful heart, disdainful act in the body of Christ, they will make the heart of many people wax cold. They will not want to go to church again. They're just tired. They don't want to be anywhere. Some people will say, and if you invite them to the good one, they'll say, I'm praying. I'll pray about it because I've been messed up with many churches. And it's a lie. They don't pray about it. Someone that doesn't even go to church. What revelation you want to see about church you are going? Amen. We need to be very careful. Yes?
12. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved.
Anyone that endure to the end, the Bible says the end will be very tough for everybody, every Christian. God has not called us to the gospel of hip hop, gospel of rapping, gospel of pleasure. He called us so that we can. When the Bible says he that endure, does it mean that the gospel is easy? What is the meaning of endurance?
To bear.
To bear what? To bear tea or coffee?
No, to bear pain.
You see? Endurance is to bear hardship. When Jesus himself said, anyone that endures to the end will be saved. Which means it does not matter whether you were saved many years ago. But when you are able to endure those trouble, pain, because of the trouble, you will not backslide. You know, many people are getting back to the world. Some people leave the church of righteousness to go to the church of evil. Why? Because they cannot endure anymore. Some people say that pastor's teaching is too hard. Is heaven hard like that? Is that the way it is? No, I even have a church there. They preach the same holiness, but their one is a classic holiness. And let me just go and remember there. God is opening door there. There is miracle there too. And that's the deception. People, when they see miracle, it's finished. Once there is miracle in any church, they believe God is there. And that is why you see all those people that do all those fraudsters of before. There's no fraudsters plenty anymore. I'm talking about the heavy ones. What they have done now is just to be converted with deception to go to their villages to go and acquire some powers. And when they do that, they just demonstrate all those things because they know there is money in gospel stuff. Because they call it business. There's, as far as they're concerned, there is money. So they will go and do those things and they will move in a way that you will see that they are really doing miracles. Before you know it, 2 years is too much. The church are filled. They begin to have like 20 branches already. That is the modern day fraudsters. They don't do all those ones you see anymore. It's church. They go to Bible school. They don't care. They can learn it 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Sound in the world. When they speak, you'll be shivering on your table, on your chair. But it is utter pulpit in the front and altar at the back. You will see the pulpit where they preach, but when they go inside, you will see altar of the shrine where they will lead them. And they have their own God. And they'll come and demonstrate the miracle for you people. You must be careful. It is easy to separate evil and the bad, no matter how good they look the same. When you know, good is good and bad is bad. There is no semi-bad and semi-good. It's either good or bad. Same is same and sin is sin. When you see miracle and you don't see holiness, carry your bag and do what? It's easy. You see many miracles, you see wonder, you see everything, and you see the value that is doing miracle, just taking the new wine, LSE, and just... And that's the pastor that just do miracle. And you see the way everybody dress, even the pastor's wife, they don't care about it. They say, dress the way you like. What is in heaven? Who will send you to hell because of your dressing? Don't mind those fanatics. You be careful, mark them. It's easy to know. Because no matter how smart they are on the other side, they are never smart when they get to holiness. They will fail. They always fail in holiness. But the devil knows that area too. Now he's bringing some people to bring holiness out with deception again. They will come out with holiness, but they are not holy. They just speak it, but you need to move close there. You know that what is being said is not what is being done. You will get in before you know it. So we must be careful. Deception is coming in every corner to send people to hellfire. You must hold up to your word. This is what you need. Once you have this, you know it. Nobody can carry you with any news. If I did not know the word of God, I'm telling you, I would not be preaching here now. Even this short time of this ministry, I have seen things. People have come to me across my way, telling me what to do, how to do. Say, this is what God said. This is what God said. How can you come to a pastor that God called to say this is what God said when God has not said to that man that he called? Like I used to say, I am not a pastor that just carry Bible and say, if I'm a businessman before I became pastor. For a businessman to leave business and become pastor after seeing money, you don't deceive that person. It is difficult to deceive. What is it money I'm looking for again? In ministry, God has given me ideas, even up to now. Ideas and opportunity to make it if I want to. So if I can abandon that to want to preach, I don't think that is what I'm up to. I don't think so. Because I ran away. If you know how long I've been running away from this calling, I've realized that the Lord is willing to frustrate everything I do because of this. understand. He is the only one that knows what he sees in me. Because I cannot see anything good that God wants from somebody like me. But now I begin to see bit by bit when I go around, when I preach the gospel, when I hear testimonies from people on the phone or come to me personally. Yesterday alone, I got two wonderful conversations with two people and I was very happy. Just like I used to say, my happiness will make me fear. When I hear testimony, I will be happy, but I will be afraid. Why? Because the Bible says, he that endureth to the end will be what? Will be saved. That does not determine my salvation. I am just on the way. I don't want to miss it. When I hear this news of people, this pastor started where? He did like this. He did like this. Now look at the story that are coming out. I will say, hey, look at this pastor. Look at this one. I trust very well. Oh my God, what is happening? Oh Lord, have mercy. Oh Lord, have mercy. What is this becoming? Hey, this one. Recently, during the week, another one, they say, preach holiness and righteousness. Now look at what is happening in this ministry. This year, I say, oh my God, what is this? And they brought some people to testify to it. They started all well. Those things the Lord warned me against it when he was calling me for this ministry in the revelation. He lined those men of God up from the top to the bottom. Top ones that you can think about. The one that is reigning in the world. He showed me in that revelation. He came to me as an old man. So the old man helped me. I used to be very careful when I'm telling revelation. So the old man came and he showed me all of them lined up like this. I don't want to mention it. He said, you see that one? You see this one? They're plenty like choir. You know where choir used to sit in the church? That's where all of them stand. They didn't see that they were standing. All of them. Big ones that you know. He said, this one, there was one of them. He has a miracle ministry. Everybody know him all over the world. People travel from far and near to travel to him to get healing. And I saw that one in a dirty suit. And he's always very neat and put his hair very well and everybody body clean. I said, why is this one dirty like this? He said, that is the way his work is. Look at him. Prodigal son. You know, he didn't say prodigal, but the way he said it, that's the way I use that language. Like a child that has useless opportunity and anointing given to him. He was called. He said, all of them. Since that day, I don't call them fake ministers anymore. I stop. Because before when I do, I would say, no, I don't believe this. They are fake. Believe me, since that revelation, I don't call any pastor fake anymore. Because they all started from me. I called them. Look at that one too. But all of them are just on their own now. And they don't even know that they are already abandoned. You know when you keep somebody aside? You just leave the small gift with them. Some of them you left gift with them so that people can know that he is still the Lord. He can do miracle. So people can understand. I mean, still establish that the Lord is alive. Amen. Jesus is coming. As I'm standing before you, I have taken my decision. And from this revelation I just told you now, you know when you want to put a player in a football game, when you want to change player, you will tell the one that is going, look at, that's the mistake of that one. That's the mistake of this one you want to replace. And you now go. That was the way that revelation was me. I was supposed to go into the field like them, but I was being warned against all their mistakes. Three mistakes was common among all of them, and I will tell you so that you too can watch out for it. Three mistakes all of them made in common. Number one, they were full with obsession to have power. In the sense that they want people to know them as powerful ministers. Number two, they were obsessed with having money and to have enough so that they will not suffer again. They suffered before in ministry. And as soon as they begin to make the money, they want the money to keep on flowing. They don't want to suffer again. Number three, they wanted fame and connection. People to know them. Popular, TV, radio, everywhere. Invite them here, invite them there. They were driven by those three machinery. and they lost their presence before the Lord. If you are here and you love people to just, you just want people to like you. You just want to talk so that they can like you. You don't want to be offended. You don't want them to offend you. You don't want them to be offended by what you say. I cannot say the truth. They will hate me. They will not like me. They will not. And you kept the word that God is sending you to them. He will just throw you out. He doesn't have time. You became a politician. There are many politician Christianity. You know, they want to be good to all people so that they can be inviting them. You are good here, they are good there, they are good here. Why? Because they want to get invitation to their churches. And when they finish, they'll give them brown envelope. They will make calculation in their room. Recalculator. If I go to Redeem tomorrow, at least they have about 500 members in that church. I'm sure of about 1,000 euro after my administration. Okay. And I go to that one. At least 5 invitations a month will give me like 5,000 euro. Yes, I'll be okay. That is what they pursue. That's why they want to be nice. That's why they will not put the message that they see that to go and write. The message that will fit all those churches. That's what they will preach. Believe me, I used to tell you, nobody can invite me to anywhere. In fact, when I go to a place, they guide it for me not to get microphone. Because any opportunity to get microphone, the only thing I will say is, repent. The kingdom of God is at hand. Even if they are doing the dedication of a child. That repentance, I can preach anywhere, even if they are doing funeral. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at. Even if they are doing wedding, repent, for the kingdom of God is at. That is the message that the Lord has sent every minister. It's not the calling of evangelists. It's the calling of everybody in the body of Christ. Jesus is coming. He wasted every resources on you and on high. That is why the Bible told us the story of a prodigal son. Every resources was wasted on you. The Lord took care of you. There's a story of a tree in the Bible. The Lord, Jesus said, the owner of the garden dressed this tree. He took care of the tree. Unfortunately, I won't be able to read it. I just want to be saying the rest of the Bible passages until I just finish in Revelation soon. They dressed this tree. Took care of this tree from when the tree was planted, young. Why? Because the owner of the tree had a future plan that this tree will produce fruit. Put fertilizer, hire a laborer to take care of the tree and the garden. And it got to a stage after many years when the tree is supposed to be bringing results. The owner of the garden went there, he did not see any fruit. The tree did not produce. After all the resources, after all the investment, no result from the tree. Then the owner said, he told the laborer, said, cut this tree down. Enough is enough. We cannot continue to waste time. And the laborer said, please, my Lord, give this tree another chance. Let me work some more. Let me try some more. Let me go some more. Let me get some more effort. Let me try what I can do. Give me some time. Give me some time. A year, 2, 3, and this tree will bear fruit. Please, Father, and that is Jesus for you. The Lord would have raptured this world. He would have sent Jesus to come since. Get even if it's 20 people, go get them. When the Noah built the ark, a gigantic ark, how many people were there? Do you think God will feel that he lost anybody? We have only 20 people raptured across the world. Go, my son, go and finish these people. They are grieving my face all the time. When a man hold a man in holy matrimony, what do you think God will do? That one is not even painful enough. When the man now mounts upon a man on the bed, what does that make God look like? God will say, this is satanic. When a man clap upon a woman, it is satanic. This week, I was watching on the internet, on the newspaper on the internet. They caught a white man that came, I don't know which country, to Kenya to shoot a video of a dog. He brought a dog to sleep with some ladies. And they were shooting the video when somebody saw and caught them, and they arrested them with the ladies. And they put them on the paper. The ladies, African girls, how much would they pay them for dog to sleep with them? Now tell me, if you are God, to see your children behaving, dog sleeping with women, dog, if you were Jesus, how do you feel? Put yourself in that situation. I'm telling you, sometimes Jesus will turn his robe as a royal king in the throne. I've not seen him like that, but I'm just saying that's the way I would do. He will just turn the robe like this, probably tear you sometimes. Cha! Oh! No, Father! No, Father! Oh, no! Oh, no! Why? Why are these people like this? I died on the cross because of them. I was punished for their transgression. I was chastised for their iniquities. I went through shame and disgrace upon the street of Jerusalem. I carried cross like a slave. I was in pain and agony. I was given sour drink on the cross. They put thorns on my head like a crown. They humiliated and mocked me openly for their sakes. I didn't want to do this, but I had to do it anyway because of them. Why is it that they're wasting my grace and opportunity upon them? Anyway, my time is coming too. When I will no longer see the tears in their eyes, and I will not pity them with their tears. No matter how much they groan in hellfire, I will not have mercy on them. This is the time of mercy. The time that I've sent some people to speak to them about what I like and don't like. I have sent many people. I have revealed revelation. I have broken protocols of heaven. The plan was that I would not let anybody know the time and season. I told them that before I left. The plan is that I will not allow anybody to go from the dead to tell them when the rich man requested. But now we have been sending people again to tell them that the kingdom of God is at hand. That this is the way it's supposed to live. This is what it's supposed to do. This is what it's supposed to do. Yet! They have refused to live their life. Why are my people becoming adamant, disobedient, arrogant? Even in the church of God, my people, they preach. They tell them what they should do, to repent from their way. They refuse, even in the church, the people that are sitting now in the church. They hear the word, and as soon as they hear it, they forget as they leave the church. They tell them what it needs to do to go to my kingdom. Yet, they refuse to believe. They refuse to live according to my ways and instruction. Yet, my anger is coming one day. And there will no longer be mercy. No matter how much they cry. No matter what they shout. John chapter 14. Oh, God. Can I have 15 more minutes, please? John 14. John chapter 14, from 1 to 6, first read there.
John 14, 1 to 6.
Yes, ma'am.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Don't let your heart be troubled.
Ye believe in God.
If you believe in God.
Ye believe in God. Believe also in me.
Believe also in me.
In my Father's house are many mansions.
There are many mansions in my Father's house. If it was not so,
I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you.
If it was not so, I wouldn't have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you as I'm going now. Yes?
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whithersoever ye know, and whither I go, ye go, ye know.
Wherever I go, you go too.
And where ye know.
Amen.
Amen.
That's your version, eh? I don't want the ye and ya and yo. I want the real. Amen. We understand anyway. I was just joking. Amen. Amen. So, Jesus declared that he was the way. Because the people didn't know. He said, if it was. Do you think Jesus Christ will lie? Do you think he will lie about the kingdom of God? He said, there are many mansions. He didn't call it apartment. And I give glory to God. I pray that God should show me, and I was shown. You need to pray it yourself now if you want. God, if there is a mansion in heaven, if there is a house, I need to know. He will show you. Like I told you before, I had a revelation where I was kept. God just used that to show me some certain things. Where I was kept in heaven, I had a revelation that I was raptured, and I was kept in the cage as my apartment. That place you could not even stand up. I said, what kind of house is this? So I didn't have a house or what? I was just there and I was seeing some angels. I don't like this place. So, and that place you cannot revolt. You cannot fight against anything. Where you are, you just have to stay there. It's not in this world that you can say, I don't like this way, I move. And you begin to write something in the placard and begin to lift it and you begin to do riots on the street. You can't do that in heaven. And all of a sudden, through mercy, just to cut that revelation short because of time, they just opened the door and one angel just came. He said, we're asked to bring you to another place. Because a book of record was opened. Of what? Of your good deeds. Generosity on heart. Let's go. I said, thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. I was walking. They were taking me. We crossed. There was another area we crossed. That was just apartments. We crossed the place. I said, Then, I would go to another place where mansions were. Just when I look like duplex, I say, this is the area they say we should give you one. This is more like it. So which means everything that you do is important in heaven. Good deeds, mercy. Jesus even instructed it. He said, when that day comes, I will tell you that when I was in the prison, you visited me. When I had no clothes, you gave me clothes. When I had no food, all those things that good deeds, heaven records it. Apart from your holiness and righteousness, those works of your hand, they matter in heaven. It's not only tithes and offering, but unfortunately, it's the failure of the pastors. They preach only about tithes and offering. They don't preach how you can help other people. The only preaching Jesus taught us what about giving is about helping your neighbors as yourself. But we just preach about what we come to us as pastors. Give, he shall be given unto you. Good precious chicken together. And falling over. Bring your tithe. Give. Bring your offering. Give. And that is it. What about the next person to you? What is his problem? What is he going through? That is not my message today. The Lord is coming. And his reward is coming quickly with him. Before my time today on this message runs out, I want to reach quickly Revelation 20. And I read from verse 10 quickly to the end. And I read Revelation 21 and we will finish there. Then the devil who deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophets are. And they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Then I saw a great white throne, and him who sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away. And there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, standing before God. And books were opened, and another book was opened. And which is the book of life. And the dead were judged according to their works. According to what? Their works, by the things which they were written in the books. Everything you do here, whether anybody see you or not, you know, anything, just take like this. Fat, you know, some people are smart. And just, it's written. Everything is written. Everything is written in the book. And the books will open, and another books will open of every of your acts when you are living, after you are dead here. Or when the rapture comes. The sea give up the dead who were in it. You see, every dead body, those people that die in water, you say, maybe those people will not go. The sea, the Bible said the sea will give up the dead body. It will bring them out. Because everybody must answer to the judgment. And the dead and Hades deliver up to them who were in them. And they will judge each one according to these books. To the judgment of that report that is in the books. Then the dead and the aged were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second day. And anyone, listen to this very well. Anyone that is not found written in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. Anyone whose name is not found in the book of life. Oh, those are the hunger that I'm talking to you about, the hunger and the pain that come from the pain of Jesus. Anyone that they check the book and say, what is your name? You know, it's when you die, when somebody dies, whether you like it or not, whether you like it or not, whether you like it or not, the day will come. The day will come. No matter how old you are, you can be. If rapture does not come, you will leave this world. It's not your, nobody has power over that. I have seen people that love to leave. When death come, they were struggling, they say, I will not go. They are in the bed. Why do you think people do like that in bed when they want to die? Because they don't want to go. You know, in war. Are they sick? In the bed. The doctor say, hey, please give me man. At the end of the day, you have to go. It's time. You don't fight it. Mama, do you hear that? L'amour. Il n'y a pas quelqu'un qui peut battre avec la mort. Il n'y a personne qui peut battre avec la mort. Quand la mort vient, même si quelqu'un il est à l'hôpital, il se bat au lit à l'hôpital. Il ne veut pas mourir. Il dit non, je ne mourrai pas. Je ne vais pas, je n'ai pas envie de partir. Mais il va partir. Tout le monde doit partir. Mais avec ça, c'est jugement. Tout ce qu'on a fait dans le monde, même dans les cachettes, où personne ne voit. Mais Dieu, il a mis ça, il a enregistré tout. Et chacun va rester devant lui en jugement. Et tout ce qu'on voit qu'il y a personne qui a vu, il va ouvrir le cahier pour faire sortir tout ça. Tout ce qu'on a fait dans les cachettes, il met ça dehors. Le telle date, tu as fait ça. Tu as volé le poulet. Tu as volé l'argent. Tu as fait ça. Et sans que les noms n'aient pas trouvé dans les livres de vie. Parce que au ciel, il y a des livres de vie devant Dieu. Sans que les noms ne trouvent pas dans le livre, la livre de vie, ils partent tous en enfer. Et tous. Anyone that his name is not found in the book of life, it goes to hell. Et si ton nom n'est pas écrit dans la livre de vie, et la personne va regretter de venir au monde. Anyone that has not, that his name is not the book of life, will regret that he was ever made. Oh, I don't know what I can compare that with. You know, somebody can go to jail and you have, it's only 15, after 15 years you come out, no matter how long. But this one, there is no turning back. Dans ce monde-là, si on fait des erreurs, on peut régler ça, on peut rectifier ça. Mais erreur de rentrer en enfer, dans feu, on ne peut pas rectifier. We can no longer turn the back of the clock around when we go to hell. It is impossible to reverse. It is irreversible. It is a life of regret.